Let's continue working a little bit more with negative exponents. Looking at the quotient rule, note we write b to the m over b to the n equals b to the m minus n. Now we did the problem x squared over x to the fifth, and using this rule we got x to the negative 3, and then simplifying that, so it's a positive exponent, we wrote 1 over x cubed. So what you might notice here is since 5 is the exponent in the denominator and that's larger than 2 in the denominator, I could have gotten this answer by doing 5 minus 2, but then the x is in the denominator. So that would give me the positive exponent and I have 1 in the numerator. So b to the m over b to the n is also 1 over b to the n minus m. So when would you use it as I've written it first, b to the m over b to the n? You would usually do it when m is bigger than n, right? If the exponent in the numerator is larger, I might write it that way. And when the exponent in the denominator is larger, I might write it that way. You could write it either way, but that's when you would get positive exponents. We usually only write this one, b to the m over b to the n equals b to the m minus n. But it's important to note that you would get the right answer doing the second way I've shown you. So for instance, if I had x to the 20th over x to the 100th, since there's more in the denominator, I can then do 100 minus 20. And that should make sense to you, because if you wrote out 20 x's in the numerator and 100 in the bottom, can you imagine that 20 of them would cancel and you'd have no x factors left in the numerator, but there'd be 80 left in the denominator? So if you sort of visualize it, what's going on, this should also make sense. Okay, what if you had a fraction raised to a negative exponent? Well, the power of a quotient rule, you'd say that's a to the negative n over b to the negative n. But now anytime you have a negative exponent, you could switch it across the fraction bar to make it a positive exponent. So the a to the n would be in the denominator, b to the positive n would be in the numerator, and then note that's the same thing as just b over a to the positive n. So here's another rule you could use. If you have a fraction to a negative number, it's the reciprocal to the positive number. You don't have to memorize that. You would eventually get it by using all the other rules you know. But here's an example. What if I had 3/4 to the negative 2? Be a little quicker if I just wrote this as the reciprocal to the positive 2. Now, how can you do that? You could either think of that as 4/3 times 4/3 and get 16/9, or you could think of it as 4 squared over 3 squared and you'd also get 16/9. Let's think about this one more time. If I have x to the negative 2, we know that means 1 over x squared, correct? On the other hand, if I think of it as a fraction, x over 1 to the negative 2, it would be 1 over x to the positive 2, which is 1 over x times 1 over x, and I still get 1 over x squared. So notice you're going to get the same answer in this particular case. If you want to think of it as a fraction and do the problem that way, you can. Or it's really more direct usually to just write 1 over x squared. I just wanted to show you that if you use the new rule, you will still get the same answer. Now that you know lots of laws of exponents, you actually can work them out in different ways as long as you're always using one of the correct rules, which is basically the meaning of exponents. So how would you do m over m to the negative 3? Hopefully all of you know now not to try to cancel those m's, but you have to think about the exponent. So that's an m to the first, that's an m to the negative 3. Try it and see what you get. Put it on pause. Carry you back. Now, there's two ways to do it. One is using the quotient rule. So you're going to have m1, and you're going to minus a negative 3, right? Which is the same thing as just changing signs and just adding a positive 3. So you would have m to the fourth. Someone else may have said, well, I'm going to take this because it's got a negative exponent and put it in the numerator. So I have m to the first times m cubed, again, getting m to the fourth. So you could see, not everybody does it exactly the same way. Okay, let's look at a different problem. How about 2 to the negative 3 plus 2 to the negative 2? Now, this is an addition problem, and here's where it's very important you have to know how what negative exponents mean. They're really just fractions here. 2 to the negative 3 means 1 over 2 cubed, and 2 to the negative 2 means 1 over 2 squared. And now I'd have to get a common denominator. That's 1/8 plus 1/4. All right, what's the common denominator here? Everybody get 8? So I need to multiply this fraction by 2 over 2. So I have both of them in terms of 8s. And that would give me 1/8 plus 2/8. The answer would be 3/8. So you also have to remember how to add fractions, get a common denominator. Math is so cumulative. All right, here's one for you to try. There's power rule. You're going to have to use the quotient rule possibly. There's negative exponents. Lots of different things in here. So go ahead and put it on pause. Try this problem. Okay. So we've got x to the 16th, because I'm going to use the power rule here. I have an x to the 10th down here, but what about this x to the negative 4? I'm going to move this down to the denominator. You may have done this problem differently, but this is how I'm going to start the problem. So I have x to the 16th over x to the 14th, and now you can subtract the exponent, 16 minus 14, and get x squared. You might have done that a different way, but here's one way of getting the answer of x squared. Okay, let's try this one. Now we have to remember our rules for dividing with numbers are not the same as our rules of dividing with bases that have exponents. So when you see the 15 over 10, remember that's just still 15 divided by 10. I'm going to do this one a little bit differently. I'm going to write this by factoring 15 is 3 times 5. And this x cubed, I'm going to go across the top. This x to the negative 3 means it's in the denominator as x cubed. M cubed is positive, so I'll keep that up at top. All right, now let's do the bottom. I'm going to factor the 10. So this is times 2 times 5. The x to the negative 8, I'm going to put that in the numerator with a positive exponent, and the m is down here. And now I'm going to see if I can cancel anything, if I can use the quotient rule in any way. Let's see. So I can cancel out the 5s. Okay. So as far as my numbers go, I can see I'm going to be left with a 3 in the numerator and a 2 in the denominator, right? Okay. Now let's look at the 2x bases. So I've got 8 over 3 basically. So I'm going to subtract those exponents. That's x to the 5th. I also have m cubed over m. So remember that's the m to the 1st. So I can do the m cubed over m to the 1st is m to the 3 minus 1 m squared. Okay, and that's your answer. Again, one way to get the answer.